哈利路亚！愿各位亲爱的长辈、弟兄姐妹，大家平安。
哈利路亚 ，peace to all brothers and sisters。
我们一起来看圣经啊、来得到一些勉励。
So let's all turn to our Bible for our mutual encouragement。
我们请翻开到箴言二十四章。
Let's all turn to Proverbs 24。
箴言第二十四章。
Proverbs 24,
从三十节开始
from verse 30 on,
到三十三十三节
until verse 33.
好，三十节，我经过懒惰人的田地，无知人的葡萄园。三十一节
31.
荆棘长满了地皮，刺草遮盖的田面，石墙也坍塌了。第三十二节
32.
我看见就留心思想，我看着就领了训诲。好，我们读到这边、哦、在这边这个作诗的人，他说他经过了懒惰人的田地。
So over here the poet, the psalmist wrote that he went past the field of the sluggard.
这个田地啊，它原来是一个葡萄园。
And in fact, this field was once a vineyard.
哦，本来是要给这个主人带来很多的益处，很多的喜乐。
So initially, this vineyard was supposed to bring much benefit to the owner.
哦，但是这个智慧的人，他看到了这个田地，却没有带给他的主人丝毫的快乐的丝毫的益处。
However, this wise man who passed by saw that this field did not give any benefit to the owner.
原来这个田地，这个葡萄园，荆棘长满了，刺草遮盖了。
Because what happened is that thorns had grown everywhere in this vineyard.
根本没有办法长出葡萄或者是什么有好的农作物。
And there's no way that grapes can grow or any other crops.
就算偶然有一两个葡萄跑出来。
So perhaps one or two grapes may appear.
石墙也坍塌了。
But however, the stone wall was also in ruins.
狐狸或者是一些其他的野兽随时可以进来，把仅有的一点点的葡萄把它吃掉。
And little foxes or even other animals can come in and eat up whatever little grapes there are left.
那这个人他有一个葡萄园，他是地主，可以算是有福的。
And so this landlord who has this field, this vineyard, in fact, he is very rich.
以色列人来到了牛奶与蜜之地。
So when we look at the Israelites, they came to the land flowing with milk and honey.
他们一直认为这个地是神所赐给他们的产业。
And so they believed that this land was a blessed inheritance from the Lord.
是从神而得的。
And it came from God.
但是这个人的田地，这个人的葡萄园，他却没有去经营它。
But however, this man did not take care of the vineyard.
所以他叫做懒惰人。
And that's why he's called the sluggard.
啊，虽然有这么有福，有田地，有葡萄园，却一点都没有得到益处。
So even though, yes, he is very rich, he has this vineyard, this field, but he did not reap anything from it.
那今天我们看了这段经文，我们呀要留心来思想。
So today, when we look at this passage, we need to ponder upon the truth.
因为我们如果真的去思想，我们就能够领了训诲。
So if we deeply think about it, we shall receive the teachings from within.
原来这个葡萄园，原来这个田地可以指的就是我们的家。
Because this field, this vineyard refers to our family today.
可以指的就是我们的小孩。
And it can also refer to our children.
因为小孩是神所赐的产业。
Because our children, they are the inheritance that God has blessed us with.
主耶稣交给我们来好好的照顾。
And that Lord Jesus, he has entrusted our children into our hands for us to take care of.
那我们有没有好好的来照顾他们呢？
So indeed, have we taken care of our little ones?
我们可以来看哥林多前书。
So let's turn to 1 Corinthians.
哥林多前书第三章。
First Corinthians chapter 3.
三章第 六节。
Verse 6.
开始哈，哥林多前书三章第六节。
First Corinthians chapter 3, verse 6.
我栽种了，亚波罗浇灌了，唯有神叫他生长。第七节。
Verse 7.
可见栽种的算不得什么，浇灌的也算不得什么，只在那叫他生长的神。第八节。
Verse 8.
栽种的和浇灌的都是一样，但将来个人要照自己的功夫得自己的赏赐。第九节。
Verse 9.
因为我们是与神同工的，你们是神所耕种的田地，所建造的房屋。好，在这边保罗把牧养信徒比喻成好像是在栽种田地。
And so over here, Paul, he looks at the pastoral work as relating to planting a field.
哦，他栽种了，然后亚波罗浇灌了，但是是神让它生长。
And so Paul, he planted the seed, Apollos watered it, but it is God who make it grow.
哦，这个田地指的就是信徒。
And so this field refers to the believers.
那今天这个田地可以指的是我们宗教教育的每一个学员。
And also for today, we can also refer to this field as each and every little students that we have.
今天早上我们讲到了，神把这个责任首先是托付给了我们的爸爸妈妈。
And this morning we spoke about how God first entrusted this responsibility to the parents themselves.
要在家里执行宗教教育。
That is, you need to have a family altar at home.
但是这个责任也交给了我们在场的每一位老师，宗教教育的老师。
And in the same way, this responsibility is also entrusted to every single RE teacher.
让我们与神来一起同工。
So that we can work together along with God.
这是多么大的一个福分，多么大的一个荣幸。
And that itself is such a great privilege and a great blessing.
神居然愿意让我跟他一起同工，来照顾好他的孩子。
That our Almighty God above is willing to work with me so that we can take care of the children together.
所以我们只管用心的来照顾。
So we only need to exert our duty and take care of our children.
各个老师互相的配合。
And that the teachers can work together as a team.
有些老师他比较会栽种。
Some teachers, they are better at planting the seed.
有些老师他比较会浇灌。
Some other teachers are better at watering the seed.
我们也是跟父母一起来配合。
And we also work together and coordinate with the parents.
只有一个目的。
There is only one purpose.
让神能够在孩子的心中兴旺起来。
And that is to allow God to grow up in the heart of our students.
让神的道理能够在孩子的生命当中扎根。
So that the truth of God can take root in the heart of our students.
神也要亲自与我们同工。
And God also will work together with us.
带领我们。
To guide us,
完成这美好的圣工
so that we can complete this beautiful and wonderful work.
最后我们再来看一个经文
And finally, let's look at another verse.
看一下，这个是在提摩太后书
And it is in 1 Timothy.
提摩太后书
2 Timothy.
提摩太后书的第三章
2 Timothy chapter 3.
第十节
Verse 10.
提摩太后书三章第十节
2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 10
但你已经服从了我的教训品行志向信心宽容爱心忍耐这个是保罗写给提摩太的一个书信
So over here it is a letter of Paul to Timothy
他可以说是提摩太的宗教教育的老师
So in the same way, Paul is likened to as a RE teacher to Timothy
他带领教导提摩太来属灵上成长。
And he guided Timothy along his spiritual growth.
但是我们发现说，他教给提摩太的不只是教训而已。
But however, we find out that in fact it is not just the teachings that Paul gave to Timothy.
所以我们今天做老师的、做家长的，我们给孩子不能够只到教训而已。
So today, in the same way as RE teacher, as parents, we do not just impart teachings to our students.
教训非常的重要。
Yes, teaching is very important.
我们一定要教导孩子关于圣经里面的教训。
And of course, we need to teach the children in terms of the truth of the Bible.
圣经里面的故事。
And the stories of the Bible.
这些都是教训。
And all these are teachings.
但是我们不能够只停在教导教训。
But however, let us not just stop right here.
我们要让学生能够效法我们的品行，志向信心、宽容、爱心以及忍耐。
But rather, we must allow our students or our children to learn from us our way of life, our purpose, faith, patience, love, and endurance.
所以我们作为宗教教育教员，作为家长的。
So that is why, as RE teachers and as parents,
我们不只是用我们的嘴巴来用神的话教导孩子。
We are not just using our lips to teach the teachings of God to our children.
更是把神的话实在的放在我们的心中。
But rather, we allow the word of God to take root in our own heart.
实在的应用在我们的生活当中。
And to apply it to our daily lives.
让这短暂孩子成长的过程当中，他跟我们在一起的时候，能够看到，能够效法。
So that during this very short phase of development and growth of our children, they can witness our way of life and they can imitate our conduct.
相信主必定在接下一年当中与你同工。
And I believe that God will continue to guide us for the upcoming RE year.
愿神祝福各位。
And may God bless everyone.
So thank God for Preacher Tony's wonderful encouragement.
谢谢国传道的勉励。
So now we'd like to take this opportunity to invite a representative from the RE parents.
借由这个特别的机会，我们要请我们宗教教育系的一位家长。
So that's Sister Janice.
Janice 姐妹。
Hallelujah, in the name of our Lord Jesus, I would like to share with everyone from the perspective as a parent.
感谢神，让我有机会在这里做一个简短的分享。
And praise and thank God that I can have a short sharing session with everyone.
感谢神的带领，今天我们真耶稣教会有一个严谨的宗教教育系统。
And praise and thank God that today, the True Jesus Church, we have a wonderful RE system that has been established.
让孩子们在成长过程中，无论是属灵上还是身心上都受益匪浅。
So that as our children are growing up, they can benefit a great deal from the RE system, whether it's spiritually speaking or in their daily lives.
相信许多父母都深有同感。
And I believe that all the parents also feel the same way as I do.
从幼稚班到高级班，孩子们在救主耶稣基督恩典和知识上渐渐地长大成熟。
And as we witness our children growing up from the kindergarten class all the way up to senior youth, we see how they grow, develop, and mature along the way.
就如同圣经记载，我们请翻到希伯来书五章的十三节跟十四节。
And just like what the Bible has recorded, as in Hebrews chapter 5, 第几节？
五章的十三节跟十四节。
Chapter 5, verse 13-14.
十三，凡只能吃奶的，都不熟练仁义的道理，因为他是婴孩。
And so for everyone who partakes only of milk is unskilled in the word of righteousness, for he is a baby.
十四，唯独长大成人的才能吃干粮，他们的心窍习练得通达，就能分辨好歹了。
So, but solid food belongs to those who are of full age, that is, those who by reason of use have their senses exercised to discern both good and evil.
第一点，教会的宗教教育让孩子们懂得敬畏神。
And so the first point is that from the RE system, our children grow up to learn to fear God.
我家有三个小孩。
And I have three children at home.
分别在幼稚班、中级班和高级班。
And so they are in the kindergarten class, the junior class, and also the senior class.
所以我可以观察到他们，他们每一个人在属灵上、生命上的成长。
And so therefore, I can see how and witness how they grow along the way, spiritually speaking.
其中有一个在前一段时间，他去参加了。美国的大专神训班。
And one of them recently went to the U.S. to attend the NYTS.
Yes.
To attend the NYTS.
这一次他的第一次。
And this is his first time.
然后他回来之后，他很兴奋地跟我们分享。
And so when he came back, he was very joyous and very excited to share with us.
他非常非常的喜欢神训班这个课程。
And he was really happy, and he really enjoyed the NYTS classes.
当时我问他，你觉得辛苦吗？
But however, I asked him, was it very, very tiring for you?
他说一开始是会，但是之后完全没有。感谢神带领他，让他懂得更敬畏神。
And he says that, yes, at first it was a bit tiring, but as time goes on, I got well, and I really learned to fear God.
当孩子了解且敬畏神的道理，就是智慧的开端。
So therefore, as our children, as they learn to fear the Lord, that is the beginning of their knowledge and wisdom of God.
第二点。
Second point.
教会的宗教教育让孩子们懂得分辨好歹。
And through the RE classes, our children, they learn to discern from good and evil.
当孩子们在宗教教育上有长进的时候，就会懂得与现今的社会做出分辨。
And as our children grow up in the RE classes, they will learn to discern good and evil from the world outside.
当今学校的教育、社会的传统和文化。
And when we look at the school system nowadays, and also the worldly system outside,
跟圣经道理很多都是相违背的。
And a lot of times, it is contrary to the truth in the Bible.
但孩子们有圣经的知识，以及圣灵的浇灌滋润，让他们懂得不会去迎合这个世界。
But however, as our children are growing up, they have the word of God in their heart. They also have the Holy Spirit showered upon them. Therefore, they will not be easily influenced by the world outside.
我们家老二在宗教教育课上了五年。
And the second child that I have has been through 5 years in the RE classes.
他非常的爱神。
And he really loves God.
每天晚上，他会自己一个人在他自己房间祷告十分钟，这是任何事情都改变不了他的。
And every night he has the habit of praying for 10 minutes every night to God, and that has been his habit, and nothing will change.
然后呢，还会经常的督察我要按时来教会。
And he will also always remind me to always come to church.
还有提醒我我们的家庭查经班。
And also remind me about our daily Bible study at home in our family.
感谢神，有时候孩子们单纯喜爱神的心，反而是我们做父母的一个榜样。
So praise and thank God. Sometimes when we look at the simplicity of the hearts of our children and their love for God, that really serves as a great encouragement for us parents.
我们请翻开罗马书十二章的第二节。
Let's all turn to Romans chapter 12, verse 2.
罗马书十二章的二节。
Romans chapter 12, verse 2.
不要效法这个世界，只要心意更新而变化，叫你们查验何为神的善良、纯全、可喜悦的旨意。
Verse 2, and do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
感谢神，我的分享到此。
And praise and thank God, this concludes my sharing for today.
求主耶稣纪念我们宗教教育所有老师们的辛苦。
And may God remember all the toil and the labor of our RE teachers.
也求主耶稣祝福宗教教育所有的孩子们。
And also may God continue to bless all the students of our RE classes.
愿一切荣耀、颂赞、尊贵都归于天上的真神。
And may all the glory and praise be given to the holy name of our God above.
Hallelujah, Amen.
Hallelujah, Amen.
谢谢。 We thank God for Sister Janice's wonderful sharing.
谢谢, Janice 姐妹非常感动的一个感言。
And now we'd like to hear from RE student representative.
现在我们要邀请我们宗教教育系的一个学生。
And we'd like to invite Sister Megan.
我们邀请Megan 姐妹。
Let's all bow our heads and pray in silence.
让我们大家一起低头默祷。
Amen.
Amen.
In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, I share a few words of reflection.
奉主耶稣圣名在这里说几句感言的话。
So honestly, I never thought this day would come where I graduate from the RE system.
说实在的，我从来没有想象到，终于有一天呢，我将会从我们的宗教教育系里面毕业了。
I spent my entire life in the RE system, so it's going to feel weird not walking to a classroom every week at church.
那么也就是说，我从小呢就在宗教教系里面长大，那么过了这么长的一段时间，我终于毕业了，现在没有机会再去上课了，会感到非常的不习惯。
But I think in a way it also symbolizes how I have gone through my 22 years of training of, from my family and RE classes to be able to take care of this faith by myself.
那么也就是说，现在已经是22岁的我呢，已经经过了家庭以及宗教教育系的培训，那么呢，我现在呢能够自己能够来带领我自己的信仰的过程。
So in the past 11 years that I have been in Vancouver Church, I have been blessed to go through many experiences and milestones in my faith.
那么在过去的11年中呢，在温哥华教会成长，那么我非常的有福气能够体验到很多属灵方面的体会。
So just to name a few, I made a handful of close friends here at church.
那么在教会里面呢，我也结交了很多很好的属灵的同伴。
I got to go to different out-of-town church events like SSC, CYSC, and NYTS.
那么同样的呢，我也到其他的教会呢去参加很多的学生的灵恩会。
I have gotten the opportunity to testify and serve for the Lord.
那么感谢神，我也有机会呢，能够为主耶稣做见证，而且能够侍奉神。
And God has allowed me to help nurture His children by becoming an RE teacher and youth coordinator.
那么主耶稣呢，也给我这个机会，让我自己本身呢，也可以成为宗教教育的老师，来带领以及教育下一代的学生。
And although these are many wonderful blessings that I receive from God,
那么感谢神，虽然这也都是神在一路上能够赐给我的很多的福气。
I have also experienced hardships along the way.
但是同样的呢，在这个过程当中呢，我也碰到很多的困难。
In the years, I have witnessed a few close brothers and sisters leave the church.
因为在过去的几年当中，我也亲自目睹到很多的弟兄姐妹们呢，也就是我很亲近的朋友们都离开教会了。
And I had to fight my own spiritual challenges.
所以同样的，我自己也有自己的属灵的挑战来面对。
But while facing these challenges, God sent people to help me without them even knowing that I was going through hardships.
但是当我在面对这些属灵的挑战的时候呢，神的恩典，也就是他带领很多其他的朋友们，同龄们能够来鼓励我。
So in the front of my hymn book pocket, I have notes accumulated from RE teachers, church event counselors, and also spiritual friends from Vancouver Church and also other churches.
那么在我的诗歌的在我的赞美诗的的书的前面呢，我有很多这些不同的字条卡片呢，小卡片以及字条，也都是从很多不同的宗教教育老师们他们给我的一些鼓励的话。
They are filled with encouragement, Bible verses, and reminders for me.
那么很多这些小卡片上面写着很多圣经的章节，以及很多鼓励的话来勉励我。
Little do these people know, I continue to read these notes, to help me get through the tough days.
那么很多时候呢，很多这些送给我卡片的这些老师们，他们都不晓得，在我面对挑战的时候呢，我常常会把这些小卡片拿出来再阅读。
These notes remind me of how blessed I am to be a part of this big, wonderful community I also get to call family.
那么这些小卡片也同时的能够一直的提醒我，我是在这个这么大的属灵的家庭里面长大，是一个很大的福气。
It took me a while to be able to say that about the church.
那么这也是这个感言呢，也是经过一段时间才能够让我体会到的。
But I have come to believe in this idea because I have felt the love, the care, and the support from the RE teachers, my spiritual friends, and the members.
那么我今天能够说出这个感言，也就是因为我现在已经非常的确信到我所感受到的爱以及关怀，也就是从我的这些宗教教育的老师和同龄们和信徒们所给予我的。
So though I have no siblings of my own,
那么虽然我自己本身呢没有兄弟姐妹。我是独生女。
God provided me with all of you.
那么神呢也赐给你们大家当作我的兄弟姐妹们。
And I really thank God.
那么我非常的感谢神。
So to conclude, I would like to share one of the notes written by an SSC counselor to me as mutual encouragement.
那么在结束之前呢，我想跟大家一起分享，也就是最近的一个SSC 的辅导员他给我的勉励。
She said, "Hold on to your blessings, and you will never be alone."
那么她勉励我说，只要你能够抓住你的应许，抓住你的福气，你就永远不会孤独。
Fear the Lord, and He will continue to show you His will.
那么敬畏神，神必定会带领你的脚步，而且告诉你他的旨意。
Serve Him with your smile, making this world a tiny bit more wonderful.
那么用你的微笑呢来侍奉神，让这个世界呢能够再温暖的一点点。
All in all, do all things in the truth, and God will preserve you.
那么不管你平时怎么的处事，为人呢，都要在真理里面，那么神呢必定保守你。
So as one of your 大姐's at church.
So as. 那么当做你们其中的大姐姐。
I encourage everyone to continue to train hard, with fear and reverence.
那么我希望呢，在这里能够鼓励大家，能够继续的，在宗教教育系里面长大，而且接受很多的不同的训练。
To pray hard for one another.
那么彼此的互相的祷告以及代祷。
To remember God's love.
那么同时呢，也要纪念神的伟大的爱。
And hold fast to God, for He will hold fast onto you.
那么记住，你要抓紧神，那么神同样呢也会抓紧你。
So I end my sharing here.
那么我在这里呢，结束我和大家的分享。
May all the honor, glory, and praise be unto His holy name.
愿一切荣耀都归于天上的真神。
So we thank God for Sister Megan's wonderful sharing.
谢谢 Megan 姐妹你美好的分享。
Now we'd like to take this opportunity to present gifts to the RE students.
现在到了我们最快乐的时间，就是颁发学员礼物的时间。
As an encouragement for all of their hard work and diligence in their classes.
这些礼物是为了我们这些宗教教育的学生，你们在这一整学年来的辛苦与努力。
So first, we'd like to start with the kindergarten class.
首先，我们先从幼稚班。
And we'd like to ask Preacher Wu to come forward to present the gifts.
我们请吴传道来颁发礼物。
So starting from the kindergarten class.
幼稚班。
We'd like to ask Brother Ebenezer.
我们请明晨到台前来。
And then go get your gift.And then wait to take a picture.
那要等一下，我们要照相哦。
Look that way.
啊！好，拿着。 明晨很有礼貌哦，说谢谢。
So next we have Sister Chloe.
我们请 Chloe 姐妹。
And next, we have Sister Faith.
Fei Fei.
And then next, we have Sister Leah.
Lele.
And now we have Sister Azaria.
那我们请晨曦。
So thank God that concludes the kindergarten class.
谢谢幼稚班可爱的小朋友。
Next, we'll move on to the E1 class.
我们接下来要颁奖的是幼年班。
We'd like to invite Deacon Matthew.
我们请马太执事。
So we have one student graduating from E1, moving on to E2.
我们有一位毕业奖要从幼年班进到另外一班。
So Sister Hannah.
我们请 Hannah 姐妹。
Now we have three encouragement gifts for the E1 class.
接下来有鼓励奖。
So we'll start with Brother Jonah.
Jonah 弟兄。
And we'll have Sister JC.
JC, 姐妹。
And Sister Jayla.
Jayla, JC 的妹妹。
Thank God that concludes the E1 class.
好，我们现在要预备另外一班少年班。
So for E2, we'd like to invite Deaconess Wang.
我们请王执事。
So for E2, we're going to have a participation award.
那我们有一位有一个进步奖。
So we'd like to, Brother Ivan.
Ivan 弟兄。
And next we have Brother Nathan.
Nathan, 进步奖。
So these students have shown a tremendous improvement in class in their participation in Bible knowledge.
这两位进步奖是对于他们这一整学年来他们有非常努力的表现。
So next we're going to have a love award.
我们接下来要颁发幼年少年班的爱心奖。
So Brother Tobias. Next, we have Brother Caleb. And Brother Luke. And this love award is for students who showed love for one another and helping one another in class.
这爱心奖是颁发给这些学员，他们在教室里面展现他们无比的爱心。
So this concludes E2.
以上呢是少年班。
For J1 and J2, we only have one student graduating.
那我们的这个初中级班呢，只有一位毕业生。
It's Brother Titus, but he's in Calgary.
那我们有一位学生就是 Titus, 他目前随着杨传道家住在卡加利。
We'll mail him his gift.
我们会把他的礼物特别专程的寄过去。
So next is a senior youth.
接下来是高级班。
And we'd like to invite Preacher Tony to hand out the award.
我们请郭传道。
Sister Megan.
Megan 姐妹。
So thank God this concludes the gifts.
这是我们的颁奖。
So we'd like to use, now we'd like to use the opportunity to introduce the RE teachers for the 2023-2024 year.
接下来我们要向各位介绍的是未来这个新的学年2023-2024年我们的各班的老师。
So starting with the RE administrative team.
我们先从宗教教育股。
It's me and Sister Susie.
那系负责是
，I'm the RE coordinator.
秘书 Susie 姐妹
，and she's the secretary. So now we'd like to invite the RE teachers to come to the front as we announce you.
那接下来我们要介绍各班的老师，请老师听到名字后，请到台前。
So for the lead teacher of kindergarten.
幼稚班的班负责。
So we have Sister Vicky.
Vicky 姐妹。
And then as teachers, we have Sister Grace.Emily, Yongqi, and Jamie, which is a teacher in training.
请幼稚班的老师到台前来。
So next is the E1 class.
接下来要介绍的是幼年班。
The lead teacher will be Sister Huan.
班负责 Huan 姐妹。
And they'll have Sister Susie, Renee, Brother Jeremy, who's a teacher in training, and Sister Claire, who's a teacher in training. Brother Jeremy, the teacher assistant. So if you can go for...So next, we'll be going on to elementary two.
接下来要介绍少年班。
So we have Sister Grace as the lead teacher.
Grace 姐妹班负责。
We'll have Sister Metha, Jiao Jiao, Megan, and Brother Brandon. For the J1 and J2 combined class,
接下来是初中级班。
We'll have Sister Janice as the head teacher.
班负责是 Janice 姐妹。
Sister Lucy, Brother Will, and Brother Andy. Thank you. For senior youth, we'll have Sister Vanessa as the lead teacher.
接下来是高级班 Vanessa 姐妹是班负责。
So we'll have Deacon John, Deaconess Emmanuel, and Sister Annie, and Preacher Tony, Deacon Matthew, and Brother Michael.
小猪猪
So thank God that concludes the introduction of the RE teachers.
这是各班的老师介绍。
So now we'd like to conclude with a hymn and prayer.
接下来我们要唱诗祷告。
So let's all rise up and sing hymn of praise 492.
那么请大家起立唱赞美诗492首。